Colorectal cancer is the third leading cause of cancer deaths among American men and women. Unfortunately, most colorectal cancers are silent tumors. They grow slowly and often do not produce symptoms until they reach a large size. Dr. Anna Garza of Methodist Hospital in Arcadia tells us that colorectal cancer is preventable and curable if detected early.
The diagnosis is really by colonoscopy. So the colonoscopy is the best way to look because we can look at cancers and sometimes even remove them through the colonoscope. So it's a very nice screening tool. It's a great diagnostic tool and a great therapeutic tool. So we can identify the cancers and sometimes even treat them. Cancers usually start as a polyp. And to go from a polyp to a cancer takes a number of years. So a polyp is a growth. So it's an area where the tissue just grows a little bit abnormal. We believe that those cells, over time, change and then turn into a cancer. So we consider polyps precancer lesions. So if we do the colonoscopy early enough, we can see a polyp and then remove it before it turns into a cancer. Once it becomes a cancer, then it gets a little bit more complicated, but we usually offer surgery to deal with it.
Dr. Garza tells us some of the possible warning signs.
Colorectal cancer does not really have symptoms. So when you start having symptoms, we get worried that we're dealing with a situation that's a little bit more advanced. We get worried about symptoms of bleeding, change in bowel habits, weight loss, anemia. There are some theories that people that are constipated may have a higher risk of developing colon cancer. So the thought is that the toxins are staying in your colon longer, therefore you're at higher risk. But the reality is people that have colon cancer don't necessarily have constipation. So there isn't a direct correlation between constipation and colon cancer development. But what it is a reason to look. One thing that patients need to understand is that having pain in your abdomen or pain in your anal area is not considered normal. A lot of patients come in and they say they have pain and they've been ignoring it for years because they've feel like it's their hemorrhoids. And really, pain is not a normal symptom to have, especially not a symptom of hemorrhoids. So it really needs to get evaluated.
Dr. Garza explains the colonoscopy procedure.
There's a lot of anxiety with the thought of having a colonoscopy and the process of a colonoscopy. And the reality is that the colonoscopy part, you're sedated, so you don't remember it nor feel anything. So that's actually the easiest part of the colonoscopy. So the day before, you start drinking a special solution that will clean your colon out. You do that at your own home. And then the next day you come in, we put an IV in your vein, give you some sedation, and then do the colonoscopy. So it actually is a very easy procedure. The hardest part of the procedure is the bowel prep. So once the bowel prep is completed, everything else is easy. The procedure itself is about 20 minutes. And then because you've received sedation, you usually recover for about 45 minutes. So if you had your colonoscopy early in the morning, you could be home for breakfast. The different thing about colonoscopies when you compare it to breast cancer screening or prostate cancer screening is that we actually can intervene and stop the cancer. The recommendations are if you're 50 years old, you should have a colonoscopy. If you're completely asymptomatic and have no family history, then 50 years old would be the time you start. If you've had rectal bleeding or any of the other symptoms that we've talked about, constipation, change in bowel habits, or if you have a family history, then we screen you earlier. And that really depends on your symptoms. Once you start having symptoms, then we like to do the colonoscopy. If you have a strong family history, we like to start the colonoscopy at age 40 or 10 years earlier than the age of diagnosis in your family.